Hello friends, we are starting today with the questions on functional budgets. As we discussed earlier, the functional budgets relate to every function of business. It starts probably from the sales budget for the product, for the output. Then we go on to production budget, which is pure quantitative budget for the product or the output. Then using input-output ratio, we reach consumption budget of the material. From consumption, we reach purchase budget for the material. Then we reach labor budget, other overhead budgets, which is normally followed by the budgeted income statement, which is to be prepared in marginal costing format. We are starting with questions there. Question B1 is what I would like to discuss first. So if I read B1, it relates to a single product which is called product P. They are making finished bags of P and selling. The target is 50,000 bags of P at a selling price of 9 per bag. The question does not want me to make sale budget. Otherwise, it is quite simple. 50,000 into 9, 450,000 is budgeted sales revenue. That is simple sale budget. But he is not asking that because there is nothing in that. For the purpose of income statement, we'll get the budgeted sale revenue at 50,000 into 9, 450,000. He tells me input-output ratio. There are exactly 3 materials to be used in making finished bag of P. By reading point B, we follow there are 2 materials, Q and R. But there is a third material hidden in the question, which is known as empty bag. The input output ratio for Q and R is given in point B. The empty bag input output ratio is not given. And how did I get to know that there is a third input? If you read second point in the requirement, you are required to prepare raw material purchase budget for Q, R and empty bag. So there is a third material also which is to be considered, which is empty bag. Now question arises, what is the input-output ratio for empty bag? How many empty bags are required to produce one finished bag of P? By simple common sense, for one unit of finished bag, you need one empty bag. For every finished bag, I will require one empty bag in which I will fill the output and sell it to the customer. You can call it assumption, but that is the only assumption we can take. That is very logical, simple assumption that we are taking, that for one finished bag of P, I will require one empty bag of P. So third input is empty bag. I need to make consumption budget of that and reach purchase budget in the second part of the question. In third part, he wants me to compute variable cost to produce. Mark the word to produce. Produce is the key word there. And in last step, last fourth part, he wants me to make budgeted income statement that will be under marginal costing format again. So what I'm doing here, I'm explaining part by part all computations of this question number B1 of your assignment. We start with production budget. The format that I've explained you for production budget: budgeted sale quantity, add target ending inventory. Target ending inventory means closing stock of the product or finished bag, less opening inventory, opening stock. From there, I'll get production units. So if you look here, what I am getting, budgeted sale quantity, 50,000 bags given in the question. Budgeted sale quantity, 50,000 bags given in the question. Add target ending inventory. Ending inventory, they are given in point C. If you look there, second column, finished bag of P in numbers is given. End of quarter, 11,000 is there. So 11,000 bags is the closing stock. Less opening stock, just above that, 15,000 units is the closing stock. Beginning of quarter is opening stock. So opening stock is to be reduced to 15,000 bags. 50,000 plus 11,000 minus 15,000 makes 46,000 bags. So required production, budgeted production for the quarter is 46,000 bags. This figure is very, very important because it will be used in next budgets. In consumption, consumption shall be based on production. Consumption is never based on sale. Based on consumption will be purchase. Now what I need input-output ratios. I reach part number 2, that is making of purchase budget. First is sale, second is production, third will be consumption, fourth will be purchase. So first I need to get consumption, in that I adjust the stocks of materials and I will get the purchase. Remember the sequence in all questions, it is going to be exactly same. There is no difference question by question, only there can be multiple products instead of single product. There can be single material, there can be multiple materials. Concepts will not change question by question. This is all practice that you have to do along with me. You can always do ahead of me and then check from what I have done. You can pause the video, read the next question, do the next question, then follow the video and check what you have done correct, what you have done incorrect. Wherever problems arise, you must note them. Where is the problem? What you are doing wrong? In case you need any more help, you may call me on my WhatsApp. You may leave a message under this. I like to respond to all the questions that you'll be facing. What you are selling? Product. In this question, finished bag. What you are producing? Product. In this question, still finished bag. What you are consuming? Materials. How many? 3. Q, R, empty bag. What you are purchasing? Materials again, Q, R and empty bag. So next budget, second part, purchase budget. The purchase budget is based on materials. Will be starting with consumption. So if you look carefully, there is budgeted consumption. What is consumption based on? Input-output ratio multiplied by busted production units. Busted production was 46,000 bags. I read B point again. Each bag of P required 2.5 kg of material Q and 7.5 kg of material called R. So if I multiply 46,000 with 2.5, I'll get Q's consumption. With 7.5, I'll get R's consumption. An empty bag, I told you, call it assumption, call it implication. It's very natural. One finished bag will require one empty bag. If question says it will require 5 bags, I'll put 5. But when question is silent, by default, one finished bag shall require one empty bag. So 46,000 empty bags are required. So I have got here quantities of consumption. 1,15,000 kg, 3,45,000 kg are, and empty bag is 46,000 bags. Did it want consumption budget from you? No. So I'm not putting that in monetary terms because question did not ask. Question wants purchase only. So I adjust the stocks. Stocks are there in C point of the question again. For Q, closing stock 26,000, opening stock 32,000, given in the question. It is third column in part C, point number C, which is given, raw material Q. Similarly, next column, raw material R, 47,000 end of quarter, matlab closing, and 57,000 opening. That is what I am putting. Add 47,000, less 57,000. Similarly, 28,000 closing, 37,000 opening. That is for empty bags. When I do that add and less, be very sure closing added, opening subtracted. In all my tables that I make, brackets represent minus. Brackets represent minus. So having done adjustment, busted purchase quantity that I am getting there. This is 1,09,000, 3,35,000 and 37,000 bags. First two are in kgs, third one is in number of bags. Is purchase budget complete? Read second point carefully. prepare raw material purchase budget for QR empty bag for the said quarter in quantity as well as in rupees. As well as in rupees. So I need to find amount also. What I need to do? Quantity of material multiplied by purchase price per unit, per kg or per bag depending on the material. From there I'll get the amount. So that is what I have done in the next part there. Purchase cost per unit. When you multiply, you get purchase cost in rupees. Add them, aggregate them. You will get total busted purchase cost, which is 2,27,400. This is a complete part number 2 of this question. I hope it is clear. We started from sale, reached production for the finished bag. Apply input-output ratio, we got consumption. Adjusted closing and opening stock of materials, we got purchase quantity. Multiplied with rate of purchase, purchase cost per unit, we got purchase cost. Aggregated, we got total purchase cost. That is part number 2. Part number 3. Very simple, but word important there, to produce. Try to focus on word to produce. I want variable cost. But I want only the variable cost till the product is produced. Means I don't want to add variable marketing cost. If I'm going to give any sales commission, I'm going to incur any variable cost at the time of sale. I don't want to add that in part number 3. When I make income statement, that variable cost will also come. So be careful. It is not a total variable cost per unit. It is variable cost per unit for production only, not marketing. Marketing variable cost is also there in point number G. That variable cost will not come in third part, it will come in fourth part. So what I am doing? I am collecting all variable cost one by one. There are so many variable cost, I like to aggregate them. Material Q. Material for one finished bag, I need 2.50 kgs. How much I need? 2.50 kg. So 2.50 kg I need. At what rate it is available? 1.20 per kg. So using that, I got 3 rupees per unit as rate. For making this marker, I need 2.5 liter of ink. And 1 liter is costing me 1.20. So ink cost in this one marker will be rupees 3. Same logic here. Same logic there. For one unit of output, 2.5 kg at the rate of 1.20 per kg. Similarly, material R, 7.5 kg at the rate of 0.20 per kg, it makes 1.50 per unit. One bag required and bag is costing 80 paisa per bag. It is written there in D point. Empty bag cost 80 paisa each. So, one empty bag at the rate of 80 paisa makes 80 paisa per unit of output. Labor. It is there in E point. 9 minutes of direct labor time is there. And for 1 hour, the cost is 5 rupees. So, 9 by 60. Labor in minutes. Labor in minutes. 9 minutes. Converted into hours. 9 by 60. Multiplied by 5 rupees per hour is the rate. Which labor cost system they are applying? Time rate system. Once it is per hour, it is time rate system. If it is given per unit, they are applying piece rate system. So here time rate system, so I need number of hours so that I can multiply with rate per hour. 9 minutes, you can't say 9 into 5 because 9 is not per hour, 9 is not hours, 5 is per hour. 9 divided by 60 are hours multiplied by 5 per hour. From there, I am getting 75. Variable manufacturing overhead directly given in F point, 45 paisa. Once you add them all, you are getting variable cost per bag to produce. To produce is the key term again. We did not include variable marketing cost because it is not till the time it is produced. It is at the time of sale. Will come later on. So, answer of C part is 6.50 per bag. This is the answer of third part of the question. I hope this much is clear. Last part of the question, it relates to income statement under marginal costing format. What was the format? Busted sales revenue product wise, there is a single product. So, there is no problem of product wise. Busted sales revenue less variable cost of sale quantity. Sale quantity is the key term here. After subtracting, what I am getting is contribution. Contribution less fixed cost. Which fixed cost? All fixed cost. Manufacturing also, marketing also, administration also. What I will get? Profit. So, that income statement is being prepared in fourth part. So, you can concentrate here. Fourth part of the question. Sales value. 50,000 bags at the rate of 9 per bags makes 4,50,000. Now, what I keep saying is most important. So, what I keep saying is most important is variable cost of sale quantity. We need to take the variable cost per unit total including marketing variable cost and multiply it with sale units and not the production units. So, don't get misled by production quantity concept. You have to take variable cost of sale quantity. What is variable cost per unit in this question? Is it 6.50? No. 6.50 does not include marketing. We need to include variable cost per unit for selling, which is given there in question in G point. It is 5% of sale. For one unit, sales revenue is 9 rupees. 9 rupees into 5%, 45 paisa. So, what I am doing here, I am getting here this 5% of 9 rupees added in 6.50. So, I am getting is 6.95 per bag. 6.95 per bag multiplied by 50,000 bags. This is also important, 50,000. What I got? 347,500. Now, it is simple. Sales minus variable cost gives me contribution. Sir, what does contribution mean? You will get much more detail in the topic called marginal costing. Here, I have given you only a formula, sales minus variable cost. You will get the detailed concept in the topic called marginal costing. First day of marginal costing, you will get the first term there, that is contribution. You will get in detail. Sale minus variable cost is contribution. Less fixed cost. Look at question part F and part G. Part F tells me 30,000 fixed cost. Part G tells me another 25,000 fixed cost. And they are given per quarter. I need per quarter only. This income statement is for the quarter only. If I was making monthly, I will divide by 3. If I was making annual, I will multiply by 4. But I have to make for the quarter only. Read fourth point carefully. Net income for the said quarter. So from there only I'm getting 30 plus 25, 55,000, and I got profit 47,500. So this is what you are expected to do in the full question. Question is also saying, show total cost data. You can show variable cost plus fixed cost is total cost. Per unit, you can divide by units to tell per unit also. So everything completely done here. Profit I am getting is 47,500. This is one fundamental starting question on functional budgets. I hope this one is clear. Move on to second question, B2. If I read B2 carefully, instead of one product, there are three products. There are chairs, tables, benches. We can call them C, T and B. There are different types of material. If you read it carefully, there are three types of material. One is hidden, two are directly given. Timber is there, upholstery is there, and written in a paragraph below the first table, fixing and finishing material, that is also there. No quantitative data for fixing and finishing material. It is only cost which is given there, which we'll consider in our cost statement as well as income statement. Then there are two types of labor, carpenter and fixer and finisher. Their times are given, rate per hour are given, again time rate system applicable. And then they want me to make the income statements. So it is quite logical, similar question as B1. But it involves little more effort because number of products are more, number of materials are same three, types of labor are two. So we'll take little more effort to do the same. Let us start with this B2. We start in A part, that is production budget. Very simple. Three products, busted sale, add closing stock, less opening stock. That will give me busted production figures. So I take from question on the first para, second line, busted sale quantity is given. Busted sale quantity, chairs 4200, tables 800, benches 500. Busted sale quantity given in the question. Stocks given in point number 2. In the middle of the question, point number 2, inventory levels planned. You are given timber, upholstery, not needed here. That is for material, will come in purchase budget. This chair, table, benches. Closing stock, which I call target ending inventory, 200, 300 and 50. Opening stock given there, 400, 100 and 50. Once you adjust, what you will get? Busted production quantity. I normally put brackets for subtractions. You can also put. And then I am getting there busted production 4000, 1000 and 500. Next. For purchase budget, what I will need? For purchase budget, I will need consumption, adjustment of stocks, then purchase price, I'll get a purchase amount. But there is a problem. Problem is, for third material, which is fixing and finishing material, no quantitative details are known. I'll read for you. Point 1, below the table, timber cost 50 per cubic feet, upholstery cost 20 per square yard, fixing and finishing material cost 5% of cost of timber and upholstery. So first compute cost of timber and upholstery, add them, total cost of these two materials, add 5% more, which is fixing and finishing material. Try to understand, what is fixing and finishing material? They're talking of making a chair, table, bench. Fevicol is used there. Nails are used there. Nails means what? In Hindi, we call it kil. They use lots of kils and Fevicol. They are unable to identify quantity of that with the help of the chair table benches being produced. So, rough estimate, they say if 100 rupees are spent on timber and upholstery material, then 5 rupees will be spent on this fixing and finishing material. So, 5% of cost of timber and upholstery. So, we can add that separately in monetary terms, but not putting that in quantitative terms. The quantity is not being identified here. So, look at this detail. Material purchase budget, it is made material wise, timber and upholstery. Timber in cubic feet, upholstery in square yard. In exam also, must mention units of measurement there. They do deduct a half or one mark sometimes for not mentioning the unit of measurement. You should be perfect. When you are doing a CA exam, you should be perfect. Any professional exam, if you are appearing in, try to be perfect to get all the marks, because every single marks judges your pass or fail, rank, whatever. So, be sure that you are mentioning the unit of measurement also. For chair, you are given in point number 1 table. For chair, 0.5 cubic feet, 0.25 square yard. From there, I am getting 2000 and 1000. Similarly, for table, 1.2 and 0. For benches, 2.5 and 0. There, I get total consumption. Total consumption I am getting by adding 4450, 1000 square yard. Upholstery is same as chairs, because upholstery is not getting used in tables and benches. Upholstery is a type of cloth which is not used in tables and benches. Even otherwise, I am given input-output ratio, I will use from the question, even if the logic is not known. After adding, I get total consumption. Now, inventory again in point number 2. 650 and 260, 600 and 400. Once you add in less in brackets, what I get? Busted purchase quantity. Apply purchase cost on this 50 per cubic feet. In case of timber, it is given below the table in point number 1. Timber cost rupees 50 per cubic feet and upholstery cost rupees 20 per square yard. You get this amount. But this is not busted material cost total, because I still want to add what? Fixing and finishing material. 5% of this fixing and finishing material. That is important. Once I add, this is important part, fixing and finishing material. Once I add, what I am getting is total cost 254310 is total budgeted material purchase cost. Now I reach next budget, which is labor cost budget or direct wage cost budget, one and same thing. How many types of labor is there? Carpenter, fixer and finisher, two types. You are given input-output ratio here also. Minutes per unit are given. Minutes divided by 60 will make hours per unit. Multiply with units to be produced. All inputs and resources are dependent on units produced, except marketing cost, which can be based on sale units. We are talking labor. It is based on units produced. So, if you look here, point number 1, table row number 3, carpenter time minutes per unit. 45 minutes, 45 by 60 is hours. 60 minutes, 60 by 60. 75 minutes, 75 by 60. Fixture finisher 15 minutes, 15 minutes, 30 minutes. Divided by 60 makes it in hours. Multiplied by units. Chairs units 4000. Table units 1000. 500 for benches. For one chair, carpenter uses 45 minutes. 4000 into 45 by 60. 3000 hours he is going to put there. There you get is 3000. Similarly, 1000 fixer finisher, 1000 tables, 250, 625, 250. Add them labor wise. Carpenter total hours 4625. Total hours for fixer finisher 1500. Rate per hour given in the question below the table in point number 1, it is given in last two lines, 6 per hour for carpenter, 4.80 for fixer finisher. From there you are getting this aggregating 34950. 34950 is total budgeted direct wage cost. Now D point is asking something, even if he had not asked, that will become my working note. We are computing variable cost per unit for all three products. If he had not asked this D part, I'll be doing it in the working note because it is needed in my what? Income statement. While making income statement, I need variable cost per unit for all the three products. So looking at this, just like last question, I am putting all materials, labor, variable overhead is not there. So, I am collecting all variable cost. Material 1, timber. Material 2, upholstery. Material 3, fixing and finishing material. Labor 1, carpenter. Labor 2, fixing and finishing labor. If I add all of them, per unit, I will get total variable cost per unit. D part is asking me that, prepare a statement showing variable cost of manufacture of per unit of all three products. So, I make it product by product. Timber. Pick from first table, point number 1, timber per unit cubic feet. 0.5, 1.2, 2.5. For 1 cubic feet, the rate is 50. Similarly, upholstery 0.25 into 20, nil. Not needed for tables and benches. Now, fixing and finishing material. You need to understand this point carefully. There is what students do some error. 25 plus 5. Total cost of material other than fixing finishing material is 30. 5% of 30. So, from where did I get this 30? I got from there only. 25 plus 5. 5% of that 1.5. Similarly, 60 into 5% is 3. 125 into 5% is 6.25. Now, carpenter 45 minutes. In hours, 45 by 60 into 6, 4.5. 60 minutes means 1 hour means 6 rupees. 75 minutes divided by 60 into 6, 7.5. 15 minutes, 1 by 4 of an hour, 4.8 per hour is the rate. For fixer and finisher, rate per hour is 4.8. From there, I am getting 1.2, 1.2 and 2.4. Half hour is needed, so you are getting 2.4 in third benches. Add them all, you get 37.2, 70.2 and 141.15. It is not difficult. It is similar to what we did in B1. Only thing is there are multiple products. Instead of one product, there are three products. we need to make a table which is showing variable cost per unit for each of the three products. We reach last part of this question, which is E part, budgeted income statement. A budgeted income statement, same way, sale less variable cost of sale quantity. I keep on repeating sale quantity. That is most important. The word sale is most important here. I get contribution product by product, add them all, total contribution. In last question, that did not apply because there was single product. Here there are three products. So add them all, you get total contribution less total fixed cost, you will get the profit. Sales there, 4200 into 50, the selling price is also given there at the top before first point in the third line of the question, 50, 85 and 158. Variable cost per unit, we just computed here in D part. On sale unit, we apply, we get this. Subtract, we get a contribution for all three products. Add them all, total contribution, less fixed cost. Where is fixed cost? Read their third point. But be sure, there is some googly there. He is writing 8,000, but he is writing per month. What we are doing in question, second line of question, for the next quarter ending 31st March 1994. Even E point writes for the said quarter. Quarter is not 8,000. 8,000 is per month. We want to put for 3 months, which comprise a quarter. So for quarter, it is 24,000. Even if you have done all question correctly, you do it wrong here, you lose quantity of marks in this. So, make it sure you are reading it carefully. When it is given per month, multiplied by 3. 3 months comprise a quarter. There are 4 quarters in the year and each quarter is comprising 3 months. So, 8,000 into 3, 24,000. Once you subtract, you get the net profit. That is a complete question. It is a wonderful question for 8 marks in the exam. 6 marks, 8 marks. They are not difficult marks. There will be much more difficult questions to follow later on, but this question is comprehensive as it is giving me much more detail about all the concepts related to functional budgets.